This is the back piece for our male version of the jogging pants or trousers or pajamas or sleeping pants or whatever you want to call them. We've cut the front two leg pieces, well, we've cut the front pattern piece out. What we've done is we're using a medium size and we're using a tracing wheel, some wallpaper to actually cut our required size in this. Now we are following the measurings for a medium size. So on the with the wallpaper laid underneath, we are tracing using a tracing wheel. We are tracing around the markings for a particular size that we want to make. We don't actually want to cut into the pattern, cut into the actual pattern itself, because we want to actually use the other sizes of the pattern too later on. Now for our particular one, we are following the markings of the medium size. Just make sure you try and trace around to the actual line. Now what we need, what we can do is later on we can actually transfer some of the, it's actually given crotch line and lots of guidance also on this. This is probably one of the beauties of using a pattern compared to a freehand cutting. Obviously defining all these measurements by freehand is a lot harder than actually using a pattern. In a pattern, all the hard work has been taken out for you and you go back to basic sewing once you're Now, if you wanted to actually follow this out, you can actually use the tracing wheel to transfer these markings onto your pattern. And the reason for these actual markings are that if you were to make like a crop shorts out of this, you could actually cut along this line and use it for that. If you were to make very short shorts, you could actually crotch it up to the thigh area. So, and then also this is a part for, this is a guidance line for also elastic. We can, while we've got it actually laid out, we will actually do the elastic marks as well for a medium size. This is using a 1 inch, is it a 1 inch elastic? You don't have to actually mark this out. What you can do is just use the basic pattern measurement and just put the elastic according to that. I'm just trying to have a look, see if there's any other pieces. I don't think there's any other pieces that are needed for the particular garment that we're making. Take out the pins and you can actually fold the pattern and store it away until you actually need to use it again for another size. So what we will do is, for the moment, we're going to store this away, cut around the actual marked up garment that we've just done, then cut the actual garment itself and hopefully start to stitch these. Just always remember not to use the same scissor as your fabric cutting. Just keep a spare scissor for using on paper, as often the scissor is actually blunted by cutting paper. So what we have is the back of medium pants for a male. So just mark it out so that you are actually aware of what pieces you've cut out.